There is another use of yǒu, meaning to exist. Yǒu is negated with mei. If you want to say there is something, yǒu. If there isn't anything, mei yǒu. Yǒu is negated with mei and cannot be negated using bù. Therefore, if you say there isn't anything, you cannot say 不有. It has to be 没有. Now let's take a look at the examples. The first one, 我哥哥家, my elder brother's family, exists, or to have. 五个人, five people. You have your number, you have your noun. You need a major word to connect them. Five people, 五个人. Next example, 王律师, attorney Wang, 的, possessive 的, 家, so the family of attorney Wang has, or there is, how many children, 几个, 小孩, again, 王律师的家有几个, 小孩, they follow the same word order in both decorative sentence and a question. Here is your question pronoun to ask about number. 几个. Now let's take a look at the examples of 没有. 他家, his home, his family, 没有人, doesn't have, or there isn't any. So there's no one at home. 他家没有人. Next. 谁家, whose home? 谁家, or you can also say 谁的家. 谁家没有, doesn't have, 姐姐妹妹, older sister or younger sister. So sisters. Whose home doesn't have any sisters? Er and liang both mean two in Chinese. Er is usually used when we are counting. For example, 一二三四五六七八九十, or with the ordinal number, 第一第二第三第四. 第五,第六,第七,第八,第九,第十. Or we can continue to count within 100. 十二,二十,二十九,三十二,四十二,五十二,六十二. 七十二,八十二,九十二. Within 100, whenever we encounter two, we pronounce that as 二. Beyond 100, the last two digits, we pronounce number two still as 二. For example, this one, 一百零二. 一百二十二. With one exception. This one, 二百二十二 is okay. Or 两百二十二, it is also okay. With 两, it usually refers to quantity, and therefore is usually followed by a major word. For example, 他家, his family, his house, 有, to exist or to have. 两个人, two people. There are two people in his family. 他家有两个人. 个人 you need a major word here. Next example, 谁家 whose house, 谁家有 has or to exist, 两个 two 大学生 college students, literally 大 means big, large, 学生 means students, large students is college students.谁家有两个大学生？都 It is an adverb. It means both, all, and it indicates inclusiveness. For example, 我大哥 my elder brother, 大姐 my elder sister, 爸爸 father,都是 all of them are 医生 doctors 都是医生都 is placed before the verb it is the verb 第二个白小姐李小姐王先生 Miss 白 Miss Lee Mr. Wang 都不是All of them are not, 都不是老师。It means none of them is a teacher. Next, 白一国、李文金、王爱鹏不都是 not all of them is 纽约人 from New York.So this sentence means not all of them is from New York. That means among three of them, maybe one or two are not from New York. Compare these two sentences. The first one, none of them, 都不是。都 is placed before the verb, 不是。None of them. Not all of them, 不都是。都is still placed before the verb, but together is negated by 不. Next, 王鹏、李二、白友, these three persons 都有弟弟, all of them have brothers, 都有. Next, 李英高美、王晶都 all of them 没有照片，都没有 means none of them. None of them has a picture. Next, 李英、高美、王晶不都有工作 ，not.All of them has a job. 不都有工作。Not all of them has a job. Compare these two sentences. This one, 都没有照片。有 to have is negated by 没。都没有 means none of them has a photo. Here, 有 to have.Comes after 都有 means all of them have. And together is negated by 不都有 therefore means not all of them have. Again, you might ask, 有 isn't that negated by 没? That is true, but what 不 is negating here is not just 有 but together 都有 this part.Therefore, the negation marker is 不. Again, because 不 is negating 都有. This sentence means not all of them has a job. So one or two of these three people doesn't have a job. 李英、高美、王晶不都有工作。